This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.
A warm, cozy fire is a mesmerizing activity, whether it's in a fireplace or at a campground, but seriously, watching fire might actually be good for you. What's up, everybody? Trace here. Thanks for watching DNews. The burning of a Yule log is a tradition in some European countries around Christmas time. In the States, we just pull it up online. Campfires are great for the summertime and a great way to hold me closer to get a tiny dancing candle flame. Stories of when an ancient man first harnessed fire come off as even more important than inventing the wheel. And now a study published in Evolutionary Psychology hypothesizes that humans evolved benefits from sitting around a fire. Fire is tied to warmth, light, protection, food, and power. In the ancient world, fire could help keep you alive, but also provide some form of beauty and a way to do some contemplation. Researchers from the University of Alabama asked 226 adults to watch a video of a fireplace and then report on their experiences. They used a video of a crackling fire with sound, and on average, blood pressure decreased in the participants 5%. The longer they watched, the lower their blood pressure. The reason is tough to test, but evolutionary psychologists believe that it might have something to do with our past social behavior. Not just like yesterday, like way in the past. Archaeologists have determined Homo erectus was the very first human to use fire. That was like 2 million years ago. From an evolutionary perspective, ancient humans who spent time around fire would be protected and warm. They would cook their food, and the cooking of food set us apart from primates and allowed a larger brain to develop. Actually, cooking food lowers the caloric requirements for digestion, decreases risk of foodborne illness, increases food preservation, and so on. But let's, you know, not get off on a rant here. But what about the not obvious things? For example, a fire is the earliest example of humans using artificial light to extend their day. Anthropologists point out that once darkness sets in, most of the daywalking animals go to sleep, letting the nocturnal creatures take over the land. But with fire, Homo erectus and her offspring could stay up late fashioning tools, socially bonding, and facilitating their own betterment. On top of that, psychologists began to think about how fire affected REM sleep. Apes and monkeys only spend as much as 15% of their whole night in REM, whereas modern humans use around 25% of their sleep for REM. Having a fire nearby meant for uninterrupted sleep, as it warded off predators and let the Homo erectus get a better napus. That allowed ancient man to cement their long-term memories, have vivid dreams, create procedural memories, and those long-term memories meant for better learning and comprehension, so tools could be manufactured or complex plans could be hatched. We banded together around fires, and it was a place of safety. Over time, humans probably evolved a kinship with fire and a tie to home and safety. This would explain the deep-seated feeling of calm when we hear, see, and feel the warmth of a fire. The sound and the smell, the warmth and the light were a big part of helping shepherd us into modernity. Admittedly, this is all a lot of scientific guesswork. We can't go back in time and observe our own ancestors, so evolutionary psychologists use information gleaned from psychology, archaeology, and the theories of evolution. It does seem to fit though, doesn't it? What do you think? Let us know down in the comments, and let us know if you like watching fire. You can also check out Crystal's video over here where she says maybe sitting around a fire too much could be bad for you. And thanks a lot. See you next time on DNews.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.